everyone. So I bought the Amazon Halo. I was part of the people that was lucky enough to get early access. I got it yesterday and I've been wearing it for a little over 24 hours. Before this, and I think you guys have probably seen it on some of my videos, is this watch, Garmin Forerunner 645. One of the main reasons why I got this one is it doesn't have a touch display, and I can't stand those things, and I like it that way. So it's all buttons and all that. So I've been using this for 3 years. Garmin has a really good customer service. For my first impression since wearing this, it's fairly thin compared to that. So my first impression on this is, wow, it's nice and slick. However, as far as what I use, something like this doesn't come near. This doesn't come near to this. This collects a lot more information for me based on what I do. So this has an altimeter and it uses GPS. Not quite sure if I'll be able to do elevation on this like this one. So I don't know, because it's only been 24 hours. For today's jogging that I did, that was 1 hour, I compared both of them. As far as the data, they were fairly close. But what I noticed with Halo, the calories burned, they tend to be more generous than the Garmin. That's just for today though. I don't know how that's going to play on my day in and day out. This one is very generous with the calories burned, whereas this one, I gotta earn it. The biggest gripe I have right now for this Amazon Halo is, once you're done with the free 6 months of, they gave you 6 months free of membership. That membership allows you to have access of your tone of your voice, your body composition by taking photos of your body, some labs, and then the sleep score, I believe. And in all honesty, all four of those, I don't really care. But ultimately, this will be more expensive because of the membership if you decide to, you know, stick with the membership. Whereas I paid ahead of time on this for $400, $70 early access of me purchasing this, that's with tax. As far as the feature that I actually tried this morning when I woke up, I went ahead and did the body composition, where it takes photos of four positions. It sends you a 3D data. It also gives you an option to whether they can store your original photo in Amazon Cloud, which I opted. Based on your height, your weight, your origin of your ethnicity and whatnot, and your age, just extrapolate this information and looks at it. And I think it's fairly close. Figured it out that I'm 20% body fat, which is, I think it's, that's fairly close. Yeah, I'm pretty impressed with that part, but I really, to be honest with you, I really don't care. Because I'm all about, how does my clothes fit? And lately they've been way too loose. So I had to go from a medium running shorts to extra small running shorts. So I know with all the activity that I've been doing consistently this year, my body fat composition also changed for the better. And I can't compare this to the Whoop band because I don't own a Whoop band. So for a band to tell me, oh, I'm not recovered, I should take the rest day, it's really not my thing. I don't do that. I'd like to make that decision. So even if I feel like crap, I'm still gonna go out there, but it's not gonna be a great performance. But I made the action of getting out there and jog, however slow I went, and still did my 1 hour, if that makes sense. So overall, if you don't own a watch already that has, I guess you call it fitness tracking, sports watch like that, and you don't like the face, this would be for you, and you don't mind paying the membership fee. So yeah, it's your choice. Again, you know, if it depends on what you want for you to get as far as data. So other than that, that's my initial impression, and this is going back. I'm sorry, Amazon. Maybe once you update it in a couple of years, I'll look into it again. But yeah, in the meantime, I'm still shopping at your site. All right, everyone. Bye.